Good afternoon, everybody. Now, I would like to give you a brief introduction about the tenses. In this topic, I would like to explain four aspects. The first aspect is what is tense. The second one is types of tenses. The third one is use and formula of simple present. And the fourth one is exercises with simple present. Let I begin with the use of tenses. Tense, it is an English word. It is derived from the Latin word tempus. Tense, it is an English word. It is derived from the Latin word tempus. Tempus or tense shows time. So, there is a topic in English language that describe about the time, that is tenses. Generally, in English language, we have three types of tenses. The first one is present tense, and the second one is past tense, the third one is future tense. These three tenses has subcategorized into 12 forms, and each one has subcategorized into 4 forms. The first form of all the tenses is simple, and the second one is continuous, third one is perfect, fourth one is perfect continuous or perfect progressive. So now I would like to explain about simple present. The simple present, it is used to talk about 5 things. The first thing is habitual action. The second thing is universal truths. The third thing is general truths. The fourth one, quotations. And fifth one, scientific facts. So, in this form of the tense, we have three formulas. Three formulas. The first formula to frame positive sentences: subject plus V1 plus S, ES plus V1 plus object. The second formula to frame negative sentences, we follow subject do or does plus not plus V1 plus object. The third formula to frame interrogative sentences, it is do or does plus V1 plus object. So now we will see the examples with the simple present. For example, I play cricket. This is the positive sentences. The second sentence, I do not play cricket. It is the negative sentence. The third sentence, do I play cricket? It belongs to the interrogative sentence. So let we see detailed examples about simple present. He play cricket. So he plays cricket, and I play cricket. In the above two examples, I play cricket. Here verb 1 cannot take any S or ES, but in the second example, he plays cricket. He plays cricket. Here in this sentence, verb 1 takes place S, because if a sentence starts with third person singular, then verb 1 takes place S or ES or IES. For example, she sings well. I sing well. In the above sentence, I is the first person singular, he is the third person singular. So when a sentence begins with third person singulars like he, she, it, or names like Raju and Naresh. Okay, then a verb 1 takes place yes, yes or yes. And then we will see the five aspects of simple present. Simple present describes about the habitual actions. What are the habitual actions? Habitual actions are like our daily activities. For example, Sheila gets up at 5:30 in the morning. So these are the repeated activities of Sheila. So Sheila is the third person singular, so we used in this sentence to the verb 1 yes. If I wake up at 5:30 in the morning, I is the past person singular, and you, they, we, these are all the subjects. When a sentence starts with I, we, you, they, we cannot use yes or es to the verb 1. If a sentence starts with the third person singulars, we must be use yes or es to the verb 1. Then we see the second aspect of simple present, that is general truths. Honey tastes sweet. Generally, honey is the third person singular. Here, taste is the verb. So, honey is the third person singular. So, the verb takes place yes. And the second example, the birds fly in the sky. The birds fly in the sky. In the second example, the bird flies in the sky. See, here I gave you two examples. The bird flies in the sky, and the second one, the birds fly in the sky. In the above example, in these two examples, the first sentence belong to the third person singular, and the second example, the birds, it is the plural. So verb 1 doesn't take s or es. In the above first example, verb 1 takes place yes, yes, because the bird is the third person singular. The birds is the, it is the third person plural. So we have understand one thing here, that if a sentence starts with he, she, it, verb 1 takes place yes, yes or yes. Then the third aspect we discuss here in the simple present, universal truths also. Universal truths. Generally, the sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east. The sun is the subject and rises, it is the verb, and in the east, it is the object. So, wherever you go, USA, you visit USA and Japan, the sun will rise in the east. So, this is the universal truth. And the scientific facts. Now, we will discuss the scientific facts. All the scientific facts are belong to the simple present. So, we can say all the sentences, we can communicate with our friends, the sentences which are belong to the scientific facts, they said to be in the simple present. So now I would like to conclude my topic here. Thank you, one and all.